Hey fellow beauty finders, this is Mathias Allen, pro makeup artist in Hollywood, California. Thank you so much for clicking on this new video. So for those of you guys who are brand new to my channel, I am so excited that you are here. Every single week on Find the Beauty, I bring you pro makeup artist tips, tricks, tutorials, and product reviews. I work with women of all ages, all nationalities, all skin tones, and I bring you step-by-step instructions on exactly how to make your beauty work for you. So I hope you guys will subscribe, click thumbs up if you enjoyed this video, and always leave me a comment letting me know what you want to see more of. It's the holidays, and in this makeup demo series, I'm gonna bring you some behind the scenes hysterical moments working with my mom, Linda. Now, if you have been a follower and a fan of my YouTube channel for months, even years, then you know that I love bringing my mom, Linda, on because she is my favorite canvas to work on of all time. She lets me do so many different looks and try so many different products out and play with new techniques and do false eyelashes and overdrawn lips and contour on fleek. She lets me do it all. So for those of you guys who are not familiar with Linda and I, please, please, please do keep an open mind. I know I have a lot of followers and fans out there who think that I am very heavy-handed for women over the age of 40 or 50. And that's okay. You know, my background and my experience is in celebrity red carpet and photography work. So when I do makeup on anyone, I want it to look perfect in the photograph. Regardless of if you're a model, if you're an actress, if you are a bride, or if you're just a mother of the bride, I think it's very important to look perfect in the photograph because that's what lasts forever. So my makeup techniques are based on my experience of working with photographers and working in film and television. I hope you guys will enjoy that. In part three to this holiday makeup tutorial series with my mom, Linda, I'm gonna show you how to powder your skin if you are a mature woman. Now, not every single person out there needs to use powder, although I do recommend at least a setting spray if you want your makeup to last. Now, I'm gonna use a baking technique under my mom, Linda's eyes, and you'll see that this will create a very flawless, smooth finish and keep the concealer on no matter where you go or what climate you're in. All right, so stay tuned. I'm going to explain that step by step. So we're going to move into powder. Now, Mom, you like powder, right?
Oh, yeah.
Tell everyone out there why you like powder, because women over 40 are scared of it.
You think?
Oh, my God. I just got a comment today on another video that they stay away from powder.
Oh no.
Why do you like it?
Well, 20, 30, 40 years ago, I liked it because my skin was so oily. Mm-hmm. And now I like it after you've hydrated and put all this stuff on and whatever. Mm-hmm. I like more matte finish, and this makeup loose powder seals it. Mm-hmm. And I still have some oil in my skin. So as the night progresses, it sets it. It keeps on setting it. And if you just use powder, it falls off. And if you just use the liquid and you don't use the finishing powder.
Stick to your face.
Yes, but my magic hair works. Comes in there and it sticks to it and whatever. So I love it.
So I'm going to use the RCMA Translucent Loose Powder, and I'm going to go ahead and set Linda's face with this fantastic new brush from Morphe. This is the Morphe R8 brush. Wait till you see how these two work together. Make sure that you don't have any imperfections under the eye before you set it with powder. Just kind of smooth that out with the warmth of your finger, and then go right in with this amazing brush that you can set and bake right underneath the eye with the loose powder. And make sure that you give yourself a heavy dose, especially if you're gonna be doing anything sparkly or shimmery on the eye, because you don't want anything to fall onto the cheek. Now, while the powder is sitting on her skin, I do the rest of her eyes, brows, and lashes. So please subscribe to my channel, because coming up next Friday and the Friday after that, the remaining portions of this series will go live. All right, so next I'm going to add some warmth to Linda's face. So I'm going to use this Soleil Cuivre number 2 from ORLANE, which is one of my favorite high-end brands. It's a very beautiful, warm, matte bronzer. And I'm going to be using this brand new Morphe R0 brush. I'm going to get enough of the bronzer all the way around the brush bristles. And because I'm using a larger brush, the color is going to go on much softer and more diffused, as opposed to using a smaller kind of fine tip blush brush, which is going to put color on in a more defined area. Now I'm using that brush with a little bit of the bronzer to go ahead and sweep away that highlighting powder that we had placed under her eye from the very beginning. This is going to also add a little bit of warmth under the eye when you sweep away that light powder so that you don't get a raccoon effect.
I got an old driver's license picture that's in black and white. It really looks like a raccoon.
I can't wait to see. Next, I'm going to use one of ANASTASIA Beverly Hills Glow Kits. Now, these come in 3 different shades. This one right here is the Glow Kit in Gleam. I'm going to add a little bit of highlight to the top of Linda's cheekbone because I want to bring back the radiance to the skin that a little bit of this loose powder has taken away. I'm using the Morphe R3 brush, and I'm going to add a little bit more pink in white, silver, gold hue right here. So I'm going to take the crushed pearl and the stardust and mix those together on the brush. Then I'm going to lightly tap right on top of Linda's cheekbone, just like so. Add a little bit of glow to the chin, add a little bit of glow to the middle of the forehead, and then just do a little bit of what's left on the brush down the center of the nose so that there's some sheen and some shine in the photos. Now, adding this glowing powder adds extreme highlight, so you do not need to do this. It is a personal preference. I hope you guys enjoyed this funny and fabulous tutorial with my mom, Linda. Make sure you look down in my description for the links to the other videos featuring her. I hope you guys have enjoyed this makeup tutorial series. If you missed any other part of this series, please do check my descriptions down below, and in my description you'll see links to the other parts of this entire series with my mom, Linda. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, I hope that you will right now, today, by clicking on this link right down here at the bottom. I do 2, sometimes 3, pro makeup artist tutorials every single week. And like I said at the beginning, I work with women of all ages and all nationalities, so no matter who you are or where you live, you will find something that is interesting and informative on my channel. Please follow me on all social media at mathias4makeup. I tweet, I'm on Instagram, Snapchat, Periscope, Facebook, and everything else in between. I would love for you guys to come along on the ride. I also do live Q&A on Facebook every single Wednesday at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. So if you guys have any questions for me and you want to talk to me in real time, you can do that by following me on Facebook. And lastly, if anyone out there watching would like to book me for a personal one-on-one makeup lesson, there are 2 ways to do that. You can meet me in Los Angeles at my studio where I can teach you one-on-one, or you can book me live over video conference from anywhere in the world without even ever leaving your home. So please go to mathias4makeup.com and find out all the information you need to know at the private education and makeup artistry trainings page. Fill out the form down at the bottom and let me know your concerns and what you want to learn, and I'll send you my rates. Thank you guys so much for watching. Happy holidays. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you had a chuckle and a giggle on me, and let me know what your thoughts were down at the bottom. Please stay tuned for one of these other 2 videos from this series or one of my other makeup tutorials for women over 40. Happy holidays and happy new year. Bye for now.